Emotionally, impact is huge. And the niggly bit in the back of my head that's like, they're looking at me and going, what's wrong with his head?
Morning, I'm here to see Dr. Emma. I have an appointment today.
Well, how'd this happen? Where'd they come from? I literally have no idea.
About 20 years ago, I noticed the first lump on the back of my head. I was sitting on a plane trying to get comfortable, and all of a sudden I realized on the back of my head there was a bump. Didn't think much of it, and then all of a sudden there's one on the front of my head, and then one on the side of my head, and then over the years they just seem to have gotten bigger.
In the beginning, I didn't notice the bumps holding him back at all. I think it was because we were in the thick of little kids and life, but as time went on and the bumps got bigger, he started to fade to the background more.
The big prominent bump right here in front is the key thing that jumps out. It's the first thing that I see every morning when I look in the mirror. I hate it. The bump on the back of my head, at the size that it's at now, makes it really difficult and uncomfortable to sleep.
I just woke up, tossed and turned all night.
I get headaches, I get irritable real easy, and it affects work. I just really need to rest.
I've always been worried whenever I noticed a change in their size. I don't know what's in there, but if it gets too big, where does it go? You know, and what happens if it has nowhere else to grow?
I am from Chicago, and I now live in London. Anytime I've approached the GPs here or the GPs back in the US, their first question is, do they hurt? Well, no, not really. Then don't worry about them. You know, they just kind of brush it off. Because I don't know what they are, I'm nervous of having them removed, because you get cut open, and all of a sudden, what you think is nothing could be something more. If Dr. Emma could work her magic and remove these, it would mean the world to me. It would be a fresh start. It really would.
Hi, James.
Yeah.
Hi there. Hi, I'm Dr. Emma.
Hi, Dr. Emma.
Come with me. Okay.
This is my wife, Haley.
Hi, Haley. Nice to meet you as well.
Nice to meet you.
I love your accent.
Oh, I love yours.
So I can kind of maybe see why you're here.
Yep.
How long have you had that for?
I've had the bumps on my head for probably about 20 years now.
Oh, a long time.
Yeah, it was much smaller when we got married.
So it's grown with your love.
Yes,
they all have. So I've got the one here, then there's one on the back, and then I've got two small ones on the top and a bigger one on the side.
Oh, so quite a lot of them.
Yeah.
And has anybody ever told you what they are?
No, not at all. I have no idea. I mean, there's always a concern of, is it something other than just a ordinary cyst that can be taken out? But
yeah, of course. So having these on your head, how does it make you kind of feel?
Emotionally, it hurts, because I worry about what people say.
Yeah.
And having them for this long and worrying about it is really, it's taken its toll as well.
Yeah. Okay, I'm going to come in and have a close-up look at that now.
Okay.
Is that all right?
Yeah, that's fine.
And I can't wait to get in to feel it. Okay. Nothing sore whenever I touch that.
No.
Gosh, it's totally straining against the skin, isn't it? It is
like
desperate to come out.
Yeah, exactly. It looks like it's thin the skin.
And it's nice and free and moves very well. And that's the same. Gosh, that one's quite big, isn't it?
It is.
And then this guy.
Yeah.
Again, this is just all in the skin. And the same with this one on the top.
And then the other one is right there.
Oh, yeah, it's a wee tiny one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okie doke. So these all do look like and feel like pilar cysts. So I'm not worried about them from a nasty lump point of view at all.
Okay.
And they all feel very benign. But I am actually really excited, because these are some of the biggest pilar cysts that I've ever seen.
Oh, my gosh.
So I really can't wait to get in and get rid of them for you. Pilar cysts are caused by an abnormal development around where the hair follicle is. So it starts to develop in its own little ball in the skin. The wall of this cyst is thick and shiny, and it's filled with a whitey, browny material. So I think we should remove the three big ones. This one, the one on the side, and then the one on the back. The other ones are very small.
Okay.
So it's 6.5 centimeters by 5.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Pretty decent. Now, I'm just going to do a little injection. So wriggle your toes as fast as you can. Go, wriggle, wriggle, wriggle. That's very good. Well done. All nice and cozy.
Yeah, there we go.
Yeah. I'm just going to check the area before we do anything, okay? So just tell me if you feel anything sharp or sore or uncomfortable. That side feel okay?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. So now we're going down to see what we can see. So there's a good bit of skin that we need to cut out here so you don't have baggy skin in that area.
Okay.
All we're doing now is just teasing around this nice and gently, but it's very delicate. Okay, so we'll give it a squeeze now to see, but I think it might need both of us. Yeah. Should we give it a go? Oh, it's coming! Oh, no! There's a whole lot of this gunk in here. I'm going to try and preserve this as much as I can.
James, you want to see it?
Oh, wow.
It's pretty big, isn't it?
Yeah, that thing is huge.
Okay, we'll get you all stitched up.
And hopefully you shouldn't see much of the scar there.
This is the sister.
No, that's okay.
There it is. Right, we're going to give this a go and see if we can squeeze this out.
Yeah. There you go.
Yeah.
Oh! I felt it pop.
That was the money shot. It doesn't happen that often that you would actually get an explosion, because when you either make a hole big enough so that it just kind of seeps out, or the whole cyst pops out. But in his case, there was a bit of a weakening in the wall, and I'd cut that a little bit with the scalpel. So when Muddy and I pressed it to get it out the little hole, it properly exploded. Boom!
Oh, look, there's another baby one.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, it's a baby! I genuinely have never seen that before. A pilar cyst with a little baby attached to it. You're actually a grandfather because you've grown something that's now grown something.
Oh, wow. Well, that's pretty cool.
Isn't it? And then the back one, which is going to be the big one.
Just trying to go down nice and slowly until we meet it. I can see the little case that it lives in.
There it goes, it's popped. It's really runny. It's just quite fibrous around this one. I mean, you can tell this has been here for a while. Okay, Muddy, should we give it a squeeze now? 1, 2, 3, go. Flippin' heck, that is a beauty. That is amazing. Oh. That is really remarkable. Sure. I have never removed a cyst that looks as big as this.
Well done, you.
Thank you.
You want to see?
What the? That is huge.
I've loved you for so long.
You've been in my head forever. Goodbye.
The whole thing was a lot of fun. James is such a great patient, and I think he'll be so grateful to see them gone. It looks pretty epic now, James.
Oh, that's amazing. Wow.
So it'll still look a little bit red and a little bit bumpy for about a few weeks, but once the stitches are out, that'll all be lovely.
Oh, perfect. This will be amazing.
Hi, Haley.
Hi.
So we're all done?
Oh, my God. Oh, wow.
You can see what size it was.
Oh my God.
Squirty cream topping.
So cool.
But that was fun.
I am feeling ecstatic that Dr. Emmett was able to help today. I'm excited that now that they're gone, especially the bump on the back of my head, I'm looking forward to being able to get in bed tonight and sleep.
Seeing Jim happy now that his bumps are gone is amazing. And I can't wait for the bandages to come off.